Hey, what's up, family? Welcome to Blessed and Highly Flavored. Thank you again for joining me. Today, we are making my sister's famous pot roast, and I'm very excited because you're going to definitely love this one. So here we go. So here are our ingredients. We have short ribs, which are cut into 2-inch diameters, about 1.5-inch thickness. I just had the butcher cut them like that. We have cream of mushroom and French onion soup, white wine, some olive oil, some celery, carrots, and mushrooms. I kind of cut them to the same length so that they cook evenly. And we also have garlic, salt, and pepper, and that's it. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to salt and pepper the short ribs really good. Let's go ahead and salt and pepper that. And then the next step, we're going to flour, well, dust it with flour so that this process will help sear in the juices and the moistness of the meat. Make sure that every corner is coated with flour, just like that. Now, in a heavy bottom pan, we'll go ahead and add some olive oil, and we're going to sear each side of the short rib, ensuring that the moistness will come in. Usually this pot roast is made with a large piece of pot roast beef bone in. But in this case, I decided to use short ribs just because it's a little bit more elegant. And I just like the taste of it. And we're going to definitely leave the bone in. It adds just another depth of flavor. So as you can see, this is how it's going to look as it's seared. And just go ahead and flip it to the next side. All right, here is our seared meat. We're going to go ahead and just cover this up. And we're going to place it in the oven at 400 degrees for 1 hour. Covered. Alright, so this is how it looks. As you can see, a lot of the fat has come off the short ribs, and that's what you want. You're going to actually sear your vegetables in there. So go ahead and take them out gently. Make sure that the bone stays in, because you want to serve it with the bone in still, so you could identify what kind of cut of meat it is. So go ahead and add that garlic into the drippings. And then saute that in there. Go ahead and add the vegetables, which are the carrots and the celery. And just go ahead and just mix that up. Next step is the white wine. I use about a cup of white wine. This actually deglazes the pan and also adds a really good flavor. And the alcohol gets cooked off, so you don't have to worry about that. Next step is the mushrooms. Go ahead and just pop those in there. Give it a good mix. And then next we have our can of cream of mushroom. I like to use 4 cans of cream of mushroom and 2 cans of French onion soup. And just, incorporate that really well. All right, the next step is to add the meat back into the pot. Now we're going to cover this up and go ahead and put it back in the oven at 300 degrees for another hour. And here we have our pot roast. Man, this is delicious. As you can see, the thickness is perfect, the gravy. And so I like to just, take a several pieces of short rib and place it over some rice. And then add a couple vegetables on there. And then lastly, just the gravy. All right, so this is my sister Alane's famous pot roast. I know that you'll love this. Thanks again for joining me on Blessed and Highly Flavored. Thank you, and God bless.